me. I heard that offense. In the book of Psalms, Psalms 4.
And yet, in many cases,
He requires us to go through the process of waiting to receive the fulfillment of the promise. Everybody in here has to wait for something or for somebody. Some of you are late this morning because you were waiting on somebody. We wait for the bus, we wait for the cab, we wait for the doctor, we wait for the lawyer. We are constantly in a waiting posture. And at times, it appears that it's not worth the wait. And yet God has given me specific instructions to inform the people of God that whatever you've been waiting for, that He told you that it's coming your way.
Amen.
He said it's worth the wait. Can I get five folk to holler? It's worth the wait. I can say that not just because of my own experiences, but we are fortunate to have on record words that were left behind by the great psalmist, the great psalter by the name of David. David has left many valuable words on record. And many of them are recorded in the book of Psalms. David was one who was gifted as a musician and as a composer. And in this particular 40th Psalm, it is difficult for us to pinpoint what caused David to say these words. But it's obvious that there was some kind of struggle, some stress that he has experienced in his life that causes him to say what he said. Some have suggested that it was his encounter with King Saul. You remember Saul was the king, and David went to present gifts to him and end up in the valley of Elah fighting him against a giant called Goliath. David was able to win the battle. And because of it, the ladies in the city, y'all know the ladies can't get you in trouble. The ladies in the city said, Saul has killed his thousands, but David has killed his 10,000. And Saul became dangerously, it is a dangerous person that is insecure. You meet them all the time, people that have such a poor self-image, low self-esteem. They're dangerous when they are insecure. And Saul, who was the king, was insecure over a servant by the name of David. But how many know if God has it for you, it is for you. You don't have to go behind people's back. You don't have to connive. You don't have to try to be slick. If God has a place for you, He will elevate you when He gets ready to. And so Saul decided that David is a dangerous customer, and I got to get rid of him. You'd be surprised at the folk that got, I want to get rid of you. Sometimes they're on your job, sometimes they're in your own house, and sometimes sitting on the same road. Touch your neighbor's, I hope it's not you. but when I look at David had to flee for his life, and yet God protected him. Some said it was Absalom, his son, who